Hey everyone, welcome to Wildlife Inspired. Today, a quick opinion on sharpness with wildlife photography and what really matters, right after this. If you came here looking for a video on how to create sharper wildlife images, this probably isn't the one for you. This isn't a tutorial or a how-to. There's a million videos out there about how to create sharper images. This video though, before you get to those or before you leave this, I want you to give me 10 minutes to talk about the importance of sharpness and why sometimes we overemphasize it. And I'll give you an example. I was watching a YouTube video that had popped up in my feed, and it was about 10 tips to create better bird photography. And of course, I'm going to be interested in this and see if what this person has out there. So I watched the video and I couldn't get past the first tip, which was create shutter speeds as high as possible. And the recommended shutter speed, I believe, was 1/1600th of a second to 1/2000th of a second. With kind of like the minimum of 1/1000th of a second. I just kind of cringed when I heard this because actually very rarely do I ever shoot shutter speed that high. And as a bird photographer, we are often taught that we need those shutter speeds, especially for beginners looking like, what do I need to do? People starting to learn. They're getting some advice that I don't think is great. And here's why. High shutter speeds of 1/2000th of a second require a lot of light, a lot of light, which often means direct hard light, sun at a higher angle, sun much brighter. And those aren't always the most flattering images. My belief is that the best images, especially for portraiture, come from the use of softer light and early morning light or late evening light. When you've got that golden hour, even blue hour, there's just a quality, a tonal quality to light that is so much better. However, there's a sacrifice that we make to get that light, which is it's often lower, meaning they're not as much available. So what do you do? Well, you gotta lower your shutter speed. And I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna pull up a series here of images. I'm gonna split the screen. And all of the images here are taken at under 1/500th of a second. Now, if I included images at 1/500th, which is kind of my everyday shutter speed, that's my base point. That's where I start from. I'll go up a little if I need to or down a little if I need to based off of available light. But if I added 1/500th of a second, I would have just hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of images to show here. These are all taken at under those shutter speeds, with about half of these at 250th of a second and several of them around 1/100th of a second. Now, if I was to listen to advice and eliminate all of my shutter speeds below 1/1000th of a second, I would have a very limited portfolio, because my belief is that the best images come in soft, either overcast light or light that has a very tonal quality, like the ones you're seeing here. To me, these are pretty. Would I get a sharper image at 1/1000th of a second? I would, but I would also introduce so much noise to these images that they might not be usable and the quality might suffer a lot. So I encourage you, be careful what you listen to out there. The advice I was giving on this particular YouTube video was by somebody who wasn't even a bird photographer, yet they had a video out about how to photograph birds. They were, I don't know if they landscape or they did studio work or something like that, but they weren't a dedicated wildlife photographer and certainly not a bird photographer. So, you know, maybe I took a little bit of offense to that. Somebody out there giving advice, it's kind of like me going out there telling somebody how to do boudoir pictures or street photography. Just because you own a camera and know how to use it doesn't mean you understand all genres. The thing that's so specific about wildlife is wildlife photography is a different beast in terms of what skill sets make you good. It's not about technical knowledge of the camera and how to use it and what settings. A lot of it involves time in the field and study of behavior. So I have a lot of respect for those wildlife photographers who are out there in the field and even offering great advice about how to take better images. But maybe this one just kind of rubbed me the wrong way because it wasn't somebody who's even a bird photographer and their starting point was get your shutter speed up as close to 1/2000th of a second as possible. So just real quick, I want to talk about shutter speeds. There's a rule of inverse. It's a very common beginner rule, which says that take your focal length and put a 1 over the top. So take the reciprocal of that and shoot at that shutter speed as the minimum. So 500 millimeter lens, 1/500th of a second. If for some reason you put a teleconverter on there or whatever, and you had a 640 millimeter equivalent, then you'd be at 1/640th of a second. And on crop sensors, they would tell you to bump that up even higher. So that on a crop sensor camera, you might have to go up to 750 or 1,000 shutter speed to get a sharp image. That is not true. You can get a sharp image at any shutter speed, as long as the subject is still and as long as you have very little motion. So you do need a stable base. One thing I want to point out with this, none of this is taken off of a tripod either. All of this is either handheld or on a monopod. So shooting at 250th of a second on a monopod, having a subject that is moving maybe a little bit, there are some ways to get around that or help yourself out. And the biggest thing is to shoot in bursts. Get your frame rate up as high as your camera will allow. That's practical. I shoot around 10 frames a second, by the way, so I'm not shooting at 20 frames a second. And what that will do is it will help isolate or work out any movement of the camera and subject. And while not every frame may be tack sharp, you're gonna find frames in there that are. And for portraiture, we're not capturing action. So we really don't need that one split second. If I've got a bird perched for 2 or 3 seconds and I can get 20 frames of that bird on the perch, I'll find one that's sharp and that will work. What I can't do is take bad light, hard, strong, harsh light, and make it pretty. What I can do is work in soft light with slower shutter speeds and attempt to use some techniques like fast frame rate to find an image that is acceptably sharp. And let's talk real quickly about what is acceptably sharp. I have this theory that there's a couple groups of types of photographers, and one are technicians. And technicians are people who believe that their job as a photographer is to capture as much accurate information as possible, regardless of whether it's pretty or not. To them, maybe aesthetics and pretty is replication of reality. So hyper-focused on detail, hyper-focused on maybe not having any movement, hyper-focused on maybe capturing their subject all in a depth of field. An artist, on the other hand, will focus more on things like light and mood and image. And I would group myself more towards that than the technician. I like sharp images. I'd love to get every image tack sharp. Honestly, it's not important. I've got images hanging on my wall. Some of my favorite prints are not razor sharp, but they're just pretty. They're just pretty. And that to me is what matters. So for yourself, you're going to have to find a level of what is acceptably sharp versus what is tack sharp. I would every day of the week take an acceptably sharp image, like some of the ones you're looking at here that are pretty and have a nice soft mood, nice soft feeling, and that aren't tack sharp, versus a tack sharp image in bad light that doesn't look very good. That's not an image I would ever want to put on my wall. But I think some of these, and actually there's a couple in here that I actually have printed. I've got a couple on my wall, I think, or printed back there for sale of these images that I'm showing you. Again, all taken at slow shutter speeds. There's one that's going to come around in a minute, and I'm going to stop it because I want to talk about the quality of light that you can only get at certain times of day. And because of that, you have to shoot, or you should shoot at slower shutter speeds before you start introducing a crazy amount of noise that's just not usable. So that's kind of my premise. That's how I feel about this subject. I'm not hyper-focused on tack sharp images, and I would encourage you to just explore. Find out what type of photographer you are and what you want to be before you get locked into rules. There's tons of great wildlife photographers and bird photographers out there, and some of us will be giving you different advice. Find the advice that works for you. If you like the style of my images, then you're going to have to be comfortable shooting in lower light with possibly slower shutter speeds. If you are one of those technicians that likes that hyper focus and that, you know, razor sharp detail, you probably will need a little bit faster shutter speed. And because of that, you're also going to need more available light. And at that point, you run the risk of having maybe hard or harsh, unpleasing light to get that accomplished. So that's kind of what I wanted to talk about today. As this image loops around, I think it's going to be coming up in a minute. Hope you enjoyed the images. I tried to just pick some over the last year that I had taken that were under these slower shutter speeds. Again, many of these at 250th of a second, none of them off tripods. All of them either handheld or off of a monopod. So it can be done. You absolutely can produce pleasing images at slower shutter speeds. And I'm not going to get into a big thing. I may do another thing on shutter speeds and how they affect the images and what to look at. But this was just more of an opinion piece about why you can get away with slower shutter speeds and the trade-offs between aesthetics and detail and what you're comfortable with. As this image rolls around, I want to stop here. This image was taken at 1/100th of a second, which a lot of people would say you can't do bird photography handheld. This was off of a monopod, but you can't do it at 1/100th of a second. And this is it. This is an acceptably sharp image. I could print this easily at 11x14, which is kind of my most common print size. What you can't replicate here in hard light or more light is these pleasing tones. This is right at sunrise. You can see some golden quality hitting some foreground leaves. The background's in shadow. It's got a nice kind of mood to it. The throat on the common yellow throat, which is a tiny little warbler, is mirrored in those golden tones up top. So to me, this is a very pretty portrait. I really, really like this. Had I had the mindset that I have to shoot at 1/1000th of a second, I wouldn't even be out here at that time of day, because it's impossible for me to shoot at 1/1000th of a second right at daybreak. I'd be tempted to wait until the sun was much stronger and I could get that shutter speed up. So you don't want to just get locked into that mentality. And I think that's the big point of this. Be careful of the advice that's out there. Don't be afraid to experiment with slower shutter speeds. And if you're a new photographer, experiment. Really play around and see what you can do at those shutter speeds that may not be advisable by other people. That's my advice to you. I'll wrap up now. So quick video, hopefully I illustrated the points with those examples of some of the photographs I've taken at slower shutter speeds. Again, the main thing here is figure out who you are as a photographer. If you gravitate toward the technician, then this may be a struggle for you. Not getting those tack sharp, razor sharp images all the time could be a real challenge. But for people that gravitate toward the pretty and the pleasing, the quality of the light is more important. And sometimes you will have to sacrifice shutter speeds. You may miss a few, but if you shoot with those bursts, I think you'll find that you will get plenty of images that are acceptably sharp with shutter speeds as low as 250th of a second, even 1/100th of a second when you have to. Again, none of this was shot off of a tripod. Most of this was handheld or monopod. So you can absolutely do this. There is a belief sometimes that we need these rock solid tripod bases and we need these high shutter speeds to create sharp images. And while that does increase your chances of sharp images, a lot of times you're going to sacrifice that pretty light. So thanks for your support on the channel in general. Hope you liked the video. Down in the comments below, tell me what you think. And if you're not subscribed, go ahead and do that now. Thanks for your ongoing support and hope we can continue to find inspiration in wildlife together.